Boeing's popular 787 Dreamliner is facing a new manufacturing defect, which might sound familiar.
This is another blow for Boeing.
The defect could take 3 weeks to address, which means airlines won't be receiving Dreamliners in time for much of the busy summer travel season.
Recent issues with the plane maker's wide-body aircraft stretch back to last summer. Since then, the defects have prompted regulatory review, a halting of deliveries, a pileup of more than 100 planes, and are now pressuring Boeing's bottom line.
This is not a situation Boeing wants to be in at this point. Right now, it can't deliver its most popular wide-body aircraft. It's almost as if a company like Apple couldn't deliver laptops.
So what are the issues with the Dreamliner? And how did Boeing get here? First, a bit of background. The 787 Dreamliner made its commercial debut in 2011.
It promised all sorts of possibilities for new routes, new efficiencies for airlines, a better passenger experience, and then it wound up on the ground.
In early 2013, a fire broke out aboard an empty Dreamliner in Boston, sparked by battery problems that later surfaced on another Dreamliner in Japan.
In 2 weeks' time, we saw two cases of battery failures on the 787 and the grounding of the entire fleet by the FAA.
So the Dreamliner had to emerge from that experience and regain the confidence of airlines and the traveling public.
The 787 is now one of Boeing's most popular aircraft. More than 60 airlines, including American and United, have added 787s to their fleet. The Dreamliner is unique, as it was Boeing's first plane designed largely by other companies. Its primary structure is made mostly from composite materials for efficiency.
Because the Dreamliner's structure is new in the world of aircraft manufacturing, Boeing and the FAA are learning how its composite materials and where those materials join age over time.
So fast forward, nearly a decade of flights later, to August of last year, when Boeing voluntarily grounded eight Dreamliners, found with two different production defects in the same location.
For an aircraft manufacturer to do that on its own is something that you really don't see that often.
The defects were outlined in an August 31st internal Federal Aviation Administration memo, which was reviewed and then reported on by the Wall Street Journal.
We first reported about the Dreamliner issues in September when the FAA launched a high-level review of Boeing's Dreamliner manufacturing processes. At that time, Boeing and the FAA were trying to get their heads around the problem, and they focused on one general area of the aircraft.
Specifically, the FAA memo says they were looking at non-conforming sections of the rear fuselage, or body of the plane, that fell short of its own engineering standards. The first defect had to do with how Boeing used shims, or the material that fills the gaps between sections of the fuselage. The second stemmed from variations in the smoothness of the fuselage skin.
While the two types of defects, independent of each other, didn't pose an immediate safety risk, together in the same section were deemed to potentially introduce a risk of a structural integrity problem in extreme circumstances.
Then, the following day, Boeing flagged a third issue. This one with sections of the Dreamliner's tail that were clamped together improperly during assembly.
It's not a question of immediate structural integrity. It's a question of whether or not they introduce premature aging. And if so, what does that mean for the Dreamliners in service and how often they need to be serviced and fixed?
In a recent internal video, Boeing explained how thin these gaps are.
If you start at the tail of the airplane, just walking to the front, each of those sections, when we bring them together, is within 5/1000ths of an inch. You'll hear people talk of gaps. It's really not what you would normally think of as a gap.
The next month, in October, Boeing halted delivery of the Dreamliners.
Halting deliveries is a big deal. In effect, that means Boeing can't sell the products.
Customers largely pay Boeing on delivery. Prior to the halt, many of Boeing's commercial deliveries were Dreamliners, as the 737 MAX remained grounded following two fatal crashes of that aircraft.
Boeing was, at that point, a month away from getting the FAA's okay to again fly passengers on its 737 MAX, and suddenly it couldn't get its other popular aircraft, the Dreamliner, off the lot either.
Then, with deliveries still halted, the plane maker expanded its inspections of the Dreamliner in December after it found instances of the smoothness issue on new sections of the plane.
At that point, it became clear that the problem wasn't going away as quickly as we might have thought earlier.
In mid-March, the FAA took back Boeing's authority to inspect and sign off on several Dreamliners awaiting delivery, saying it would conduct the checks instead.
It had echoes of what happened after the 737 MAX crashes. This action by the FAA was a sign of its increasing scrutiny when it came to overseeing the manufacturing process of the Dreamliner.
But later that month, Boeing resumed Dreamliner deliveries, taking what looked like the first step toward moving past these issues. In April, the company's CEO, David Calhoun, told investors the 787 delivery pause was an example of the company trying to solve its manufacturing issues.
We've taken actions over this, really hard actions over the course of this year to stop things when we see an issue and get them fixed once and for all.
Then, in late May, deliveries were halted again as the FAA requested more information from Boeing about its proposed solution for catching and addressing the defects before handing over the planes to customers.
Boeing was hoping that it could get FAA approval for the methodology to inspect using a mix of physical inspections and analysis.
With those discussions ongoing, Boeing found the latest defect around early July, this time on part of the aircraft known as the forward pressure bulkhead at the front of the plane.
So it's going to complicate the process that was underway of Boeing trying to prove to the FAA that its methodology was sound.
It's still unclear when the latest issue will be resolved, though Boeing said it could take at least 3 weeks to address.
What we're doing on the 787 is a methodical program, reviewing the airplane from tip to tail in a way that's safe and compliant for our customers and our regulators.
Meanwhile, finished Dreamliners are piling up. More than 100 planes await delivery. Boeing has slowed production on the plane and said it now expects to deliver less than half of its 787 inventory this year.
The slowdown is likely to ripple into Boeing's vast supply network. And for some weeks and months, it's going to mean that Boeing's airline customers have to wait longer to get their new Dreamliners.
It's unclear whether these manufacturing issues will matter in the long run.
Whether or not there's any long-term impact, good or bad, to Boeing's reputation remains to be seen. For now, the Dreamliner is still a very popular aircraft and has an excellent safety record.